Hi, welcome back to another pivot table tutorial. In this video, we're going to teach you how to use slicers for dynamic interactive filtering. So I have here a pivot table we created earlier, which shows the programs crossed with progress category counts for the outcome of knowledge and skills. Now we've already covered basic principles of filtering using such features as the drop-down menu here, but this way of filtering is not really that intuitive. There's a great feature in Excel that allows you to do much more interactive filtering, and it's called a slicer. To find the slicer option, first make sure you click inside the pivot table and go up to the pivot table analyze menu. And just below that on my view is the filter submenu, and you'll see an option that says insert slicer. And let's say that we once again want to filter based on programs. So all we need to do is find our EI program field that corresponds to the program names and check that box and then click OK. And now you'll see a much slicker option for filtering. You can use this box to filter just as you would before. For example, if I want to filter on program A, I could just click that option. To deactivate the filters, you can click this little funnel option with the red X on the top right of the box. You can also use this little icon here for multi-select options. So with that enabled, you can now filter multiple options, and it's actually deselecting what I click now, and whatever is highlighted in blue is what ends up showing on the list over here toward the left. You can also move and resize this box as you wish. So if, for example, I want it down here below the box, and maybe I want to resize the box that way, maybe I want to stretch it out a little bit more, you've got all the typical kinds of formatting options that you would expect. You can also control multiple pivot tables from a single slicer. So let's try to duplicate our pivot table up top. And as we shared earlier, you would simply click and drag to encircle the entire pivot table, use your copy shortcut, paste the pivot table in a separate area, and let's back out the progress categories for knowledge and skills from the columns area and replace it perhaps with the progress categories for behavior to meet needs. Now, I typically like to add a brief descriptor above each pivot table to keep them straight. So let's call this one knowledge and skills, and this is behavior to meet needs. You can go even further again by using the report layout option to show in outline form for both of the tables. And that gives us again those descriptions of the rows and labels in each pivot table. Now, in order to avoid getting turned around with using slicers and pivot tables, it's a good idea to rename what's saved behind the scene for each of the pivot tables. So to do this, you would right-click on the pivot table and go down to Pivot Table Options. And you'll see this option at the top that says Pivot Table Name, and we want to rename this as Knowledge and Skills. And let's do the same thing for the other pivot table. Right-click, Pivot Table Options, and we'll call this Behavior to Meet Needs. Now, the last step here is to make sure that both of your pivot tables are enabled with the slicer. To do that, right-click on the slicer and go to Report Connections. And you can see, if you expand this menu a little bit, Excel is showing me every pivot table I've created so far in the entire workbook. And you can also see that most of them have a generic sounding name, which is why it was helpful to rename the specific tables that we want to connect to. So now we know for sure that it's using the Behavior to Meet Needs table and the Knowledge and Skills table. And most of the times, if these are being created in the same worksheet, Excel will recognize that it wants to connect to all of the pivot tables that have been created in that sheet. And in this case, it has, but just confirm that the right tables have been selected with the checkboxes over here on the left. And go ahead and click OK. Now, let me zoom out just a little bit so you can see both pivot tables at the same time clearly. And if I use the slicer now, you can see that it's dynamically changing both tables at the same time. This is a really handy feature for developing dashboards in particular, and we're going to demonstrate another example of this at a more advanced level in an upcoming video. So now you know how to use slicers to spruce up the way you filter your data.